and it's one of the milkweed butterflies. It is the monarch, very, very popular insect. But we're learning they're endangered, and they could go extinct if nothing changes.
Yeah, Fox 2's Margie Ellisor joining us live from the Butterfly House at Faust Park in Chesterfield with more on the monarch. Margie, what's going on?
Sad news there, Margie.
Yeah, we hate to hear this about the monarch, that's for sure. We are talking this morning with Tad. He is an entomologist here at the Butterfly House. And yeah, exactly why did the monarch land on the endangered list?
So the monarch butterfly was evaluated by the IUCN. That's an international organization that looks at data collected by biologists and scientists from around the world. And they said it's showing that their numbers are going down and going down fast. And now's the time to step in if we want to help this animal to not become extinct here in North America.
What are some reasons that they'll be on this endangered list?
So they have a lot of problems that they face throughout the entirety of their range, which is from Canada all the way down into central Mexico. The primary concerns are habitat loss, increased pressures from climate change, increased uses of herbicide and pesticide, all of which are presenting unique problems for them as they try to navigate all of these things between Canada and Mexico.
Yeah, there's some unique things about the monarch and kind of rare, including how they migrate.
Yeah, a single year-long generation of monarch butterflies, which may take about four or five total generations, will travel from central Mexico all the way up into Ontario, Canada, and other parts of Canada, and then back again. And as they travel across that range, they need food in the spring and fall, especially to fuel that migration that takes thousands of miles for them to complete. But also while they're here, they have to find milkweed to eat. The milkweed is the only food their caterpillars can survive on to complete their metamorphosis. And unfortunately, agricultural practices, along with extra pesticide and herbicide, has reduced the amount of milkweed they can find. And climate change is reducing the number of spring and fall blooming flowers available for them to fuel up and fuel that migration. As a result, their numbers are significantly decreasing.
And their lifespan in itself is pretty quick.
Yeah, yeah. As adults, most generations of monarch butterflies only live about 1 to 2 months. Everybody knows about that one generation that makes it to Mexico that can live up to 6 months. A lot of that is spent sort of as a hibernation-like state. But they need food. They can't survive very long without it. So they need those flowers. They need that milkweed. And without it, they're in trouble.
And we normally see them in St. Louis, but just for a very short time.
Exactly. We see them in the spring when they're returning from their winter months in Mexico and as they're starting to work their way north. And then we usually see big influxes of them around September, October, as they're on their way back to Mexico, sometimes coming thousands at a time, stopping, finding gardens like this where they can fuel up on the flowers and then continue to Mexico.
Yeah, you said it's just like a rest stop or a pit stop
for
them.
Stop for them, yeah.
Get them fueled up. All right, Tad, thank you so much. And